Keep Lot fans of place TV home and away. Got your exclusive ex-player interview for you today with the one and only Mr. Ian Gillard. Thank you very much, Ian, for taking the time out before the game today to have a quick chat to us about your time spent at QPR.
Yeah.
Just a few questions really regarding your time at QPR.
Yeah.
Obviously, when growing up as a boy playing football and stuff with your mates and stuff like that, and they're actually getting into football and copying it and so forth, did you follow?
Fulham.
That was my
family. Well, it was my family for local things. So I used to support them. I don't anymore.
Yeah, yeah. No, but you asked if you have an affiliation with them, which is not a problem. Yeah. Obviously, you know that was your team when you were growing up. That was what happened.
Yeah.
Okay, no problem. Next question. What year did you join QPR?
1966.
Okay.
And I come here as a schoolboy.
Okay.
And then I got signed 3 months after that as an apprentice.
Okay.
Well, tell a lie, it was 1967 that I actually signed as an apprentice, the day or the evening that I actually won the League Cup.
Oh, right.
In the hotel.
Good time to sign
with that. Alex Stock.
Yeah. Okay. What team did you make your debut for QPR?
Team, Nottingham Forest, 1968, 23rd of November.
How did we get on, do you remember?
1-2-1.
Okay. Great start for your career at QPR. Who did you score your first QPR goal against? If you can remember, obviously. Not to worry.
I haven't got a clue.
No worries, okay.
Not a clue.
No worries then.
I didn't score many, but I still can't remember.
No worries. Okay. What's the most memorable game you've played in whilst playing for QPR?
Most memorable game? I think when we beat Liverpool in the first league game at the 75 at the start of the run. We beat Liverpool 2-0.
Cool. Okay, next question. Who was your roommate on QPR away this week? Obviously you had it.
Phil Parks.
Phil Parks?
Yeah.
Is he the main one?
Yeah, he's the main one.
What was he like to room with on away games?
It was fine. We
good laugh?
Yeah, we you know, we had we used to have some of the week.
Yeah.
Relax and then bet on.
That's the right way. Okay, just a couple of questions. What's it like playing off the road when it's a full house and we're in half of the house?
Well, when it's a full house, it's electric. I mean, when we come second, I mean, that period, I mean, the gates were, you know, bumper. And it must be
good to play in when it's
it was
like that.
It was electric.
Don't get wrong, even like a half a full house, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, if the crowd are getting behind the team, the team are playing well or not so playing well, then it's like, you know, because it's so close to the pitch, obviously. Yes, that's a big factor, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you keep in contact with any of your ex-teammates from your playing days whilst at QPR? Obviously, before social media came out, and nowadays with social media, obviously, I'm the older generation, maybe not as much, but obviously you keep in contact via phones, etc.
Yeah, Jerry Francis, Phil Parks. I speak to Dave Thomas, and if he comes down here, then, you know, it's nice to see him.
Yeah.
But me and Dave, we chat probably about once a month.
Okay, that's good.
Nice.
That's good to keep in contact with some of your ex-teammates and stuff, obviously, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, what teammate had the worst dress sense at QPR?
The worst dress sense?
Yeah.
Bloody hell.
Anyone in particular?
Not really.
That you can remember,
no? No.
No worries.
Put me down. That'd be better. That solves a few problems then, doesn't it?
Okay, yeah, just one final question for myself. Can you give us an overall summary of your time spent playing for QPR, to me and to the QPR fans?
Well, I had lots of highs, I had lots of lows. The amount of time that I was here from 66 and I left in 82. You had good times, you had bad times.
Yeah.
Good times you can always remember, the bad times you can't.
And he still goes on about the penalty miss for Scotland, obviously.
Yeah.
And still it hurts him. Yeah. You know, he felt he let his family down. He felt he let the fans down.
Yeah.
But see, I think the fans don't really see that. Because obviously, as a player, you just go into, you know, back home or wherever.
Yeah.
You don't really see that. So it's a lot to take in. But yeah, it's what happens, I suppose, isn't it? There and then. But thank you very much for being Gillard for taking the time out to do a short interview myself.
Okay.
That's it from myself, Deejay Ranger, for QPR fans and players, so you'll be home and away. Come on, you arse.